In book three and book four of Korra, you see her having to get better after her battle with Sahir. What kind of research and how did you manage to figure out what Korra was going through during that period of 6 months?
Sure. Well, I mean, I've never fought an uber villain airbender voiced by Henry Rollins. I don't know if I would survive that in real life, but I have had, you know, I've definitely gone through some physical and emotional trauma in my life. When that happened and I knew that she was going to have some post-traumatic stress and stuff, that was very easy for me to connect with. And you know, that stuff, for those of you who have gone through something like that, it is sort of always there. It's just what kind of relationship you have to it. And can you... And seeing it sort of represented in sort of seeing Korra's shadow self, or seeing Korra seeing herself and the whole sort of complexity of the Avatar state in general across both series, I think is a great way of sort of looking at that. Like, what's your relationship to your pain? What's your relationship to your history and your trauma? And knowing that you're never going to be tough enough to just go, it's gone, I don't have to think about it anymore. But instead to, again, be more compassionate to others, focusing outward on others and what they've gone through was the biggest thing for me to sort of feel better about myself, which is such a great secret that they don't tell you when you're younger. Like, oh, if you just stop thinking about yourself, it's still there and you'll still be doing the work, but you'll also feel less alone. And so I think, you know, all of that Korra experiences felt very, very close to home for me. And it's also just such great writing that it's all kind of there for you. So I wish, you know, on some level, I wish I could say, oh, it's so hard because I've been so blessed in my life that I couldn't relate, but I'm actually very grateful that I could relate. Does that make sense?
Oh, absolutely.